I know everybody in the world is against Eugene Melnyk in Ottawa. And for the life of me, I cannot understand it. This guy is pouring look at the sign. A guy, no, maybe his heart's in his right place. There's a sign about Eugene Melnyk. Get out, and all the fans feel this way. I cannot believe it. Here's a guy that it spends millions of dollars. Mm-hmm. The people don't show up. As we've said many times before, there's seven rinks, sends rinks around there, Ottawa. He puts it on. The only bad rink they got is where he is. He's playing anyway. Now, listen, this guy puts up millions of dollars. Nobody comes out to, you know, say, oh, well, if they had a winning club. Yeah, they had a winning club last year. They were one shot away from getting to the finals, and they still didn't sell out. He is nuts to even stay there. He pours millions of dollars into the franchise, and what do? They give him a hard time. And the interview, you mentioned the interview.
Right. If fans are upset, because I think you're right, Don. I think people in hockey are not mad at Eugene Melnyk. They know what he's done for the city.
Well, you're saying all the fans aren't hockey people?
Well, not the people that have kids in hockey. If you have a kid in hockey, you love Eugene Melnyk for what he's done for rinks around
and
the town.
And let me tell you something. He had an interview down by the glass. You remember that? He said, why should I pour millions in when the people don't care?
Right.
And that's all I've got
and
to say.
And he said we would be better somewhere else. If it's not working in Canada, we would be better, you know.
Quebec even better.
Yeah. Wait a minute. You're suggesting he goes to Quebec?
He'd sell out in Quebec in a heartbeat. They'd never get a ticket.
Let's hope the LeBreton thing happens. That's what they need.
What?
Let's hope the LeBreton thing happens, the new grounds for the arena in Ottawa, and it's tough in a government town.
I'm just saying he shouldn't. I'm going too much time. Anyhow, let's go. The only time he ever phoned me, and I don't even know the guy, is he phoned me, should I keep Wade Redden or Chara? And he kept Wade Redden. So that.
And you said to keep. Yeah, so the fans may be right.
Nice guy, you're not too smart.
All right, Tom Wilson, your buddy, got a couple on Kerry tonight.
I love Tom Wilson. I love his dad, too. They're great guys. And, you know, I feel sorry for Price. He's got to get in the rhythm. Look at that. Look at that goal. I mean, there's no reason he shouldn't have had that goal. But Tom Wilson, boy, he's my type of guy. Look at that. He's a tough, cold turkey shots. Anyhow, it's. A good guy, good Toronto boy.
Well, what was your take on the goalie interference resolution?
All right, now, never mind showing it. I won't show it, but 2 months ago, this is what I said. They have to have a guy in Toronto, maybe two guys in Toronto, and they have to be consistent. You can't have a guy in Columbus call goaltender interference and then another guy calling in Toronto another one. You have to have one guy or two guys. They're going to have an official there. I wouldn't have an official. Get the officials out. And making the call.
Why not?
He likes other officials. He's not, they don't like to overrule the other guys and everything like that. They do not have the two guys, have them there, take the referees out of it, two guys make the decision, no problem. I said that 2 months ago, they'll do it.
Bingo, and it will be a group still. Even the guys on the ice will have a say, but they want a senior referee. So this is the funniest icing of the year. Pet peeve.
I'm always on these lines when I tell you I can't stand them. There was 30 feet. Watch this here. It makes a complete fool. Look at this guy like he's skating in mud. Look. And he calls that icing. I am telling you think it's funny. But if this was for the Stanley Cup and there was a face-off in that end, it could cost you Stanley Cup. Somebody's got to get those linesmen under control. There was 30 face-offs.
Right.
And at one period in the Pittsburgh game, you're ticking people off.
Dave Poole and John Bartlett were going crazy in Montreal, too. So here's Adam Graves and Logan watched the game the other night. Darren Pierce, who I play with on Wednesdays, watched this game. The OHL Cup, Don.
Hockey people watched it. And hockey was a jam. And there's a wild Irishman over there on the other side.
This is the minor midget championship of the world where they scout all the best prospects.
Yeah, and watch this here. And Dennis Houlihan, they put it in. Watch this here. Watch this goal. They just happened to have a game. Junior Canadians won with David Siska. They played with Dennis. He played Danny. He played with me in Ice Dogs. And this is hockey. You guys will be telling me. And here I've given a spear. You guys will be telling me, people will be telling me, you know, that Marner is a good hockey player. You know, I have people telling me, did you ever see him play? I see these guys before you even. And there was nobody from the media. There was nothing in the paper, nothing at all. And that's the greatest young hockey players coming out. They do that out West, and they do it in the Quebec League, too.
All right, we're 2 minutes, so let's just keep going for a bit. Jaden Schwartz, you predicted this too.
Watch this guy. Watch this here, Jaden Schwartz. I swear to God, I knew he was going to score. As God is my judge, I knew he was going to score. He got the two goals. He's only making $500,000. We got to hurry. All right, keep going. Keep going.
Got to do Jets. Let's go Scheifele. Mark Scheifele, amazing last night.
Got a goalie. We got somebody else must have got this. Beautiful. Now, I watch the goal he sets up on Kyle Connor. This is, and Kyle Connor, boy, he gets, this is two winners in a row he gets. Now, watch this here. He just sifts it over nice, and he puts it in the winner. And look, they don't jump around. They've got a tough club coming up. Come on.
All right, Brad Marchand, I got to nose that one out. So let's go to Sidney Crosby's goal everybody's talking about.
Bobby Rebel. All right, watch this here. We got to hurry up. Everybody's seen this one. I got one for you. Now come back to me. Bobby Orr is in California. He's killing the penalty as he's coming. And he drops his glove at center ice, and then he picks up the puck. He comes down the right side, and I'll show you what he does. Behind the net, bang, in the net. I mean, that's what Bobby Orr does. It was Gary Doak. Watch him going behind the net. See the puck? He dances like that, knocks it in like that. I just thought I'd put that in.
Coming Bobby down. Orr, the, yeah.
And you know what? It's a funny thing. I was at a party, well, having a few beers, and the guy sitting next to me said, I know that's true, Grapes, and I saw him come. He said, because I was a goalie. Suitcase Smith.
Isn't that great? Yeah. I love that he's – we'll save Anze Kopitar. He's on Hockey Night in Canada tonight. Well, sorry, Anze.
Kopitar.
No, four goals, beautiful, but we got to get to Connor McDavid because that's kind of the moral of your story here tonight.
Well, L.A., you know what I think of them. Anyhow, when I watch this here, you know, kids, I see you guys in the playoffs and girls in the playoffs. I don't know about girls, but I know you're out of the playoffs and you go through the motion. Some guys in the National Hockey League doing it right now. I don't want to name the name. This guy, think about it. He was the MVP last year. He was a toast, and he still works as hard as if he was making the playoffs, and they're not making the playoffs. Somebody thought this was a run-and-gun team they were going to go, and somebody else predicted. I don't care how good you are, and this guy never quits, and don't you ever quit, too, even though your team's out of the playoffs.
Lastly, he's got the Rockets, and so does Kelowna have the Rockets, and look at them.
Aren't they good Canadian boys? Look at that. They ever look at the coach has got one in the middle, too. I tell you, they're great boys. I love junior hockey players. I love minor midget hockey players. Best people in the world.
And that was, as you know, Don, for organ donation. So there you have Don, the big wheel Don, spokesperson on the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.